Hi Aquarius, welcome to Mirakel the Tribe. This is going to be for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising for the month of October 2018. And let's see what is going to come up for Aquarius. Pearl card. So you are ending something, definitely like a cycle is closing out for you. Something is wrapping up. Whatever that thing is, it hasn't been keeping you satisfied. Like emotionally, you were not feeling satisfied, or you want something more. So you are closing out a cycle which has been going on for a very long time, and now you feel you are bored of it. So maybe you are closing it because you want something new. Or it's a natural closing, like you saw it coming, like something is going to come to an end, and that's why it ended. So with an ending comes a new beginning, so maybe you are looking forward to a new beginning now. Messages for Aquarius. Eight of Pentacles. So you are working every day over something consistently. Like you are constantly working for something each day, every day, and it's something repetitive. So it can be a habit that you want to develop, like a new skill. You are also getting Two of Cups at the bottom of the deck. So you might be trying to pursue someone or a dream, or you are trying to understand yourself better by engaging yourself in something daily. Like it can be a meditation you are doing 5 minutes daily, or anything that you are doing daily. It's helping you with your emotional satisfaction. So some of you are also getting mutual respect and admiration and love from somebody else at workplace. Some of you are dealing with a Capricorn person, Taurus or a Virgo, and you are either going within to look for answers, or you are taking a back seat, and from behind the scenes you are working really hard over something. It also means that you want to take a relaxed approach and want to work in your leisure. I'm also seeing that you are very knowledgeable, like you are gaining a lot of knowledge through self-discovery. This is your energy. I'm getting like getting knowledge through meditation or by being still, not making a lot of noise, not rocking the boat. You're just very still and you are letting your thoughts just flow. Emotionally, you're not feeling so happy, but it's a so-so place. Like you know what you want and you're waiting for it. So you're also bored basically with what you have. You need to start something new or be enthusiastic about something. Or somebody is coming towards you with a lot of enthusiasm or playfulness. You do realize that you have a lot of options, or you are just confused which one to choose. And you're really, really confused, and definitely a start of some sort of a commitment. Not doesn't have to be relationship commitment, like a commitment at workplace, or commitment to something like a project that you want to start. Yes, like something that like a dream that you wanted to build, and now you're trying to just gather information and knowledge enough to start whatever that you always wanted to start. You could be dealing with a fire sign, Leo, Aries, and Sagittarius Sun Moon Rising. Heart of the reading is the Seven of Swords, so you are hiding something from yourself, or there is an information that you are hiding, or somebody is hiding an information from you. This can be somebody who is very sly and wicked. They are stealing something from you, or you feel that somebody is stealing something from you, and you are focused on that person. You are trying to save your energy, or you are trying to hide your ideas from this person. Pisces, I'm also getting Aquarius, Gemini, I'm also getting Scorpio and Cancer. So this person can be, or whoever it is, there is an emotional offer which is blocking you. Like somebody is making an emotional appeal to you, but you are trying to keep something to yourself. You are not sharing what is going on in your mind and what are your plans. You are not sharing, or this person is not sharing that you are dealing with. The bottom of the read is the Lovers, so yes, a Gemini card here. You have choices when it comes to people, or generally you do have choices, and they are important choices. So either you have, like, you have to make a decision and stick to it. It can be like, do you want to commit to this person or the other person, to this job or to this something else that you have, like two options. So whatever decisions you will make, it will change your destiny, or it would be a very important decision in determining where you are going in your life in few months to come. In past, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer, I'm also getting Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. This person could have approached you with a lot of emotions, and they were very stable and grounded. They understood your emotion and theirs as well. They might not have shown it, but they were emotional, and it can be you as well who is not showing emotions, and you were just sitting pretty in your emotions and not being very agitated and ruffled by whatever was going around you. You were trying to stay still and let emotions come and go. You were not getting affected, or this person was not reacting with a lot of emotions, but they were emotional. They understand other people's emotions. Now, in your mind, you're thinking, should I keep fighting for this, or should I give up? So you're thinking about, should I take it forward, or should I not? Is it worth fighting for? So if you decide it's worth fighting for, you will fight till the end, because you feel that it is worth it. In future, you are getting King of Swords. So King of Cups and King of Swords. You will have a lot of mental clarity, or this person is having a lot of mental clarity, and they are definitely not willing to show their emotions, which is very much a Scorpio I'm getting. Scorpio or Aquarius trait. So you may not be sharing your emotions with somebody, and they are showing their emotions towards you. So you're feeling that it's not appropriate for you to make decisions based on your emotions. So this can be someone who's trying to be very professional as well. Like I said, you are very calm and still. You're focused on your thoughts, and you are letting your thoughts and come and go. You don't want to rush anything. You are healing from something that has hurt you in the past. So you are taking your time, and you are not being pushed around. But someone around you is very stubborn. They are being very childish. They might force you, and they are trying to push you further. Like they are trying to press your buttons. They can be only thinking about their own idea, because they are a little bit immature. You are afraid to make a decision. You are afraid to make a decision. So you feel that I don't know what my decisions will. You are not sure about your decisions, so you are not able to decide which path to take, which one to choose, how to do that. So you are afraid of making decisions, but the way you can make a decision is by looking within, listening to your heart. So once you will listen to your heart, you will know what to do. And then you will make a decision, you will speak your truth. So I'm getting here that you should speak your truth, whatever that you are trying to hide here, that one sword or a thought that you're trying to hide here, you should speak about it to the person, or you should express yourself is what I'm getting. Communication is what I'm getting. So you will decide to communicate finally. And if you do decide to communicate, you will be victorious. There will be justice, or there can be, some of you are dealing with court cases, there will be separation. Justice will be done, truth will be spoken. And I'm getting a family will unite or a family will collapse. But mostly if it's a court case, you will win, because this is a card of victory. So in a family situation where there is a court case, separation or divorce or whatever, truth and judgment is soon going to come. And if some of you are just willing to share your emotions or your thoughts and ideas, if you decide to do that, karma is on your side, justice is on your side, and there will be some commitment and long-lasting relationships that will be formed, and it will be balanced. Only after you heal yourself, or you are dealing with a Libra or another Aquarius, so either you will heal yourself and then take that decision. And Pisces card, which is again the Hangman and the Ace of Wands below it. So something passionate you want to start, and some of you will be single because of a three-party situation or a heartbreak or the divorce that will happen, but you are happy single, not sad single, and you are enthusiastic about starting something new, like a new journey, new life after healing yourself. But you have a situation where you will go within and look for your answers and go on a spiritual upgrade before you can start something fresh. So yes, you are doing that. That was your reading, Aquarius. I hope you enjoyed. Your energy is really mellow. So while doing your reading, even I am feeling a lot calm, and I'm speaking slowly. I'll see you again, guys. Bye-bye.